Welcome back to the portfolio, everyone. And today I'm giving you my March 2020 portfolio review. I'm going to go over how my portfolio performed in the month of March, share with you the good, the bad, the ugly. And because we all know how the market performed in the month of March, there's a lot of ugly this month. Not too much good happened this month within how the portfolio performed, but that's okay. I always share exactly what happened. I don't hide anything. I don't have any reason to hide anything. I'm very transparent and like to show you my progress month over month to show you and motivate you to keep going, keep pushing, and just as well to track my own progress to keep myself personally motivated on this goal towards financial freedom. So currently the portfolio sits at a value at $29,682, down once again 20% overall because of the dip we've had in the market. Moving over to my dividend tracking spreadsheet, just to show you how my portfolio performed throughout the month, you can see here that in the month of March 2020, I received a record high of $117.19 in dividends. So of course, those dividends stayed within the portfolio, they got reinvested into more of my current holdings, and allowed me to increase my dividends each month, more and more, compounding towards financial freedom, where one day these monthly dividends will be high enough to cover all my monthly bills. Moving over to how the actual portfolio performed. Once again, though, you can also check out my previous video I made on exactly how that I received that $117. In that video, I broke down exactly what companies paid me, how much they paid me, and what I am going to do with those dividends specifically. So that's a previous video on my channel. Go check that out after this one. But of course, back to exactly what happened in March and my overall portfolio. You can see here, this is my chart of my portfolio value starting the beginning of this year, January 1st, 2020. So we started the year at a portfolio value at $29,267. So that's how we started this year, 2020. And that's when I first started tracking my dividend progress and my portfolio progress was the first of this year. So we moved on to February 1st. We saw a nice increase up to $31,320. Then beginning of this month, beginning of March 1st, 2020, portfolio sits at a value at $33,694. Then now what you can see what happened in the month of March, we see this steep decline back down, ending the month of March at a value at $30,644. So for what the chart indicates, you can see that we lost $3,000 in portfolio value in the month of March, but it was actually a lot worse. The portfolio actually lost a lot more value in that because I contributed in the month of March $2,000 of my own money into this portfolio. So in total, we've lost in portfolio value between $5,000 and $5,200 in portfolio value in the past month because of the $3,000 in portfolio value lost shown in the chart, plus the contributed $2,000 I made into the portfolio that has decreased in value, which the $2,000 offsets some of the decrease. That's why this chart doesn't show the $5,000 decline in value. Plus those reinvested dividends also got wiped out in the price depreciation over the past month. So as you can see here, the value of my chart here doesn't show too much of a steep decline, but once you really break it down and I share with you what I put into the portfolio during that time, you can see that we actually lost a little bit more value than we thought. And during the month of March, over this past time, during the strongest dips in the market, when the S&P saw the 30% overall loss, my portfolio saw a total loss right here at about 32% down. That was the lowest my portfolio hit at one time. It was over $10,000 in value lost. We've seen a slight recovery so far to end the month, and we're only down a total of 20% right now. But who knows what's going to happen moving forward. It may drop even more. We may recover. We may see a recovery and then a drop. I really don't know. I don't try to time the market, but that's just showing you how the portfolio performed with dollar-wise. Moving on, the next very important metric in my portfolio is my 12-month projected income and the growth of that 12-month projected income. I like to track my dividend income on a yearly basis. I have a long-term dividend outlook. I'm here investing for the next 10, 20, 30 years. So I have a very long-term perspective. So what I like to see is that dividend income, that passive income that comes in when I'm sleeping, grow month over month. The month of March 1st, my 12-month projected income was $1,433. That was my 12-month projected income. So if I didn't put in any money into this portfolio, if I didn't do any work, if I just slowly added on and did absolutely nothing, my portfolio will pay me in dividends, $1,433. Then by the end of March, my 12-month projected income went up to $1,472. So that increase equates to about 2.7% increase month over month. And that 2.7% may seem like nothing, right? People might think, oh, what is 2.7%? But what people have to understand is that's 2.7% growth in my annual income in one single month. Some people don't even get any raises each year in their yearly salary. Some people don't get a raise every 2 years, every 3 years. And even the people who just say are lucky enough to be in a position who work for a job where they do receive raises each year, it's very common to see a raise of 2-3% just to match inflation. So your annual salary gets one increase of 2-3% per year. My annual dividends got a 2.7% increase in one single month. And if you look at my previous months, I had a lot sharper increases. My first month, in the month of January, I got my dividend income increased by about 5%. Then in the month of February, I saw a 15.73% increase. Then this month, I saw a 2.7% increase. And why the months vary is because some of my holdings choose to increase their dividends at different points in time. For example, in February, a bunch of my holdings, about four or five of my holdings, chose to increase their dividend. That's when the company announced that their dividend is going to increase moving forward. So in that month, I saw a lot of dividend increases. As well, in the month of February, I actually contributed about $3,500 into my portfolio. So I had a lot of capital going in, which allowed me to purchase new stocks, which allowed me to severely increase my dividend income. And when I made those purchases, I actually purchased higher yielding stocks in the month of February, which is what led to this steep increase. The month of March, this past month, which is this review is about, I made purchases into low cost ETFs that actually have a little bit of a lower yield and focus more on growth. And I'll explain to you and show you exactly what I purchased next. But so they had a little bit of smaller yield. So that's why this growth in the dividend income wasn't as sharp, which is okay. I'm still take it 2.7% monthly growth. I'd love to see it. As well as, of course, we know what's going on in the market. The market has taken some sharp decline and people are no longer working. Companies are shutting their doors. So this income may actually go down. Some of my companies may actually cut their dividend moving forward. Of course, I don't want to see that, and that ruins a lot of companies' dividend history, but it may happen. So I'm just going to see what happens, wait it out. I don't know what I will do with the companies that do cut their dividend. I don't know if I'll get rid of them out of the portfolio. I don't know if I'm just going to hold them and trust that they can recover and still be strong moving forward. It depends on what companies and what happens. As well, though, you can see the chart for my 12-month projected income. Nice, steady, uphill growth, and that's what I love to see. Before I move on and show you my purchases, I would just like to go over to my YouTube channel here and thank everyone who is subscribed, who is watching the videos. I do appreciate it. Currently at 230 subscribers, which is fantastic to see. The channel is growing. My videos are getting a lot of views, and I really do appreciate everyone who takes the time to like the videos, to comment, to subscribe. It really does make me happy to see the views and hear people's comments and their opinions and see if they do like the content I'm putting out. I do try to use this channel to motivate everyone and share with them the good, the bad, the ugly of investing, and maybe give some of my knowledge and pass it on to other people. So I do appreciate, and I want to take this time to thank everyone who has stuck around, who has supported me, and I will continue to put out content moving forward, and I appreciate everyone's help. So what I purchased in the month of March, and what led to that increase in dividends was ZLB right here. So this is BMO's low volatility Canadian equity ETF. So ZLB is a unique holding. I purchased ZLB for one reason, to help offset my VDY holding. So my VDY holding, of much as many of you know, if you've watched all my previous videos, is the largest holding in my portfolio, and it's Vanguard's high dividend yield ETF. So it holds some high dividend players within Canada, which are usually very volatile. They hold the big banks, some oil companies, some energy companies, a couple utilities, and that ETF, the price fluctuates kind of severely over time. It follows the TSX follows it pretty equally. So for every 1% that TSX changes, the beta is almost one. It's very similar. Why I chose to invest in ZLB is to offset that volatility with this portfolio during the time we're in right now. So this portfolio right here, this ETF, takes the TSX 100, so the largest 100 companies within Canada by market cap. It orders them by their beta. It goes lowest beta to highest beta. And then it takes the 40 companies on the TSX 100 with the lowest beta. So if you move over to the holdings, as you can see here, it's diversified across a bunch of different sectors. It's all energy. It's all Canadian companies. And it holds EMRA, Franco-Nevada, Hydro One, Intact Financial, Waste Connection. So these are all companies that have lower betas, that their price does not fluctuate at the same rate as the TSX. The average, the five-year beta on this is about 0.7. So it has about, for every 1% the TSX changes in price, this I'm going to say ETF changes by 0.7% in price. So I want to use it to kind of offset and kind of reduce the volatility of my portfolio day in and day out. And of course, this has a strong history. They pay it. I bought it when it had about a 2.5% dividend. I really do like the holdings. It's very nicely diversified across a bunch of different sectors across Canada. And if I go over the summary and I'll show you the price history, if I go to the max, this is what I like to see. Slow and steady overall increase over time produces about a 7 to 8% overall average annual growth. Of course, you can see the dip that happened, but the entire market went down. And this has held up pretty solidly. At the lowest point, the entire TSX was down about 35, 36%. And this entire portfolio was only down about 27 to 28%. So it did hold up pretty strongly against the dip in the market. And of course, I bought it in down here. I got a nice price on it, and I will plan to hold this and add to it over the long term. So as always, I like to wrap up my videos by heading back to the portfolio, showing exactly what the portfolio sits at. Thank everyone and say, I really do appreciate all the support I've been getting. I will continue to make these videos. If you like what I've been doing, if you want to see more from my portfolio, please like and subscribe. I look forward to making the next video and seeing you there. Thanks. See you next time.